We're now joined this morning by Attorney Dino De Leon, lawyer and spokesperson of former Senator Laila De Lima. Attorney De Leon, good morning to you, sir.
Good morning, Karen, and to all our viewers.
All right. We have foreign lawmakers, especially from the European Union, following up on former Senator Laila De Lima's case. Can you give us an overview and understanding? Judge Abraham Joseph Alcantara of Branch 204 has voluntarily inhibited in her third drug case, but he cites the reason it's because he acquitted her in another case. Give us an understanding specifically of, was it necessary to inhibit?
No, it was actually the prosecution who cited the acquittal of the of Judge Alcantara of former Senator Laila De Lima. Now, to us, that is ludicrous because that is not even a ground for inhibition. This is clearly another dilatory tactic of the prosecution to prevent Senator Laila De Lima from being free. That means that the political persecution of Senator Laila De Lima, as pointed out by European lawmakers, actually continues under this administration. And as rightfully pointed out by the European lawmakers and a lot of international organizations, this is actually the Philippines reneging on its duty to uphold human rights, rule of law, and democracy. It's just so funny for us because it feels like it's the kettle calling of the other black, right? Why is it that the government is saying that its own sentinel of justice, the judge, is actually biased? So, Karen, it's very rare for the Department of Justice to be seeking out the inhibition of judges precisely because they are both sentinels of justice. They're a co-equal branch. In this particular instance, it's the DOJ who's saying its own justice system cannot be trusted, which is why they have to inhibit, they have to ask for inhibition of the trial judge. And the ground cited is not even part of the grounds as to why a judge should inhibit himself. This is a big difference. There's a big difference between the case of Judge Alcantara and Judge Buenaventura. In the case of Judge Buenaventura, his sibling, his own brother, was related to the case and was actually being alleged as the one who forced the witness to actually execute an affidavit. In this particular instance, Alcantara just acquitted Laila De Lima in another case, but it does not mean that he will also do that in this particular case, especially if there's a big difference in terms of evidence. Why is it that these two cases are different to begin with? And why is it that they separately filed it? The assumption is they have different pieces of evidence. Okay. So are they saying that they are identical?
Okay, but Attorney De Leon, just very quickly, don't the prosecutors also have a strong argument that no less than the judge granted the motion for voluntary inhibition, he says, to erase any doubt as to the impartiality. He cited impartiality of the court because, in a way, the judge himself has already ruled in favor of De Lima in another case. So in effect, any decision he makes, if he acquits her again, his impartiality would be in question.
Well, no, not necessarily, because supposedly the decision of the judge is based on evidence. Now, if the judge acquitted Senator Laila De Lima in criminal case 165 based on evidence, the assumption is the prosecution has a different set of evidence in criminal case 167. The only reason why the trial judge inhibited himself in this particular instance was just to erase any doubt. But it does not mean that there is actually a clear ground for his inhibition. In other words, he was prodded by the prosecution. You know what is quite alarming as well, Karen, to be honest, is the fact that it feels like there are already 8 judges who inhibited themselves from trying these cases.
8 judges, is that correct?
8 judges.
But this
Can you imagine?
This is from the time of former President Duterte.
Correct. Okay. But there is nothing like this case in the Philippines. This is the greatest frame-up in Philippine history. And why is it that 8 judges have recused themselves? It's because of the immense pressure being exerted on them. And what is quite alarming for us, in fact, is it felt like there was really immense pressure on the part of Judge Alcantara because we were not even allowed to, or we were not even given a chance to give our comment. The same day, a few hours when, or a few hours, or maybe less than 24 hours after the filing of the motion for inhibition, Judge Alcantara already inhibited himself from the case. No, okay. So we were not allowed to actually give a comment even.
And in terms of timeline, you've cited that this delays the freedom, in effect, the fight for freedom for former Senator Laila De Lima with the inhibition of Judge Alcantara. What is the process for the third drug case then in terms of raffling, going to another judge? How long are we talking about?
You know, Karen, that's what actually bewilders us or puzzles us at this point. No, there's going to be a raffle, supposedly, of this case, and the earliest raffle I think would be Monday next week. But who else can try this case? Yeah. Almost all judges have already recused themselves in Muntinlupa, save for I think just one judge. So is there really going to be a raffle? Let's see, right? But
is there? Does the law cite? I mean, you have a very good point, attorney. What happens if all the judges in Muntinlupa inhibit? What happens then to the accused? Right. So is there a law that actually disallows them from inhibiting and they are forced to hear a case?
You know, it is the moral obligation and the legal obligation of judges to hear a case. They cannot just recuse themselves unless there is a motion. In this particular instance, there was a motion coming from the prosecution. We believe that the motion was groundless. It's actually ridiculous just because there was a former acquittal that is not provided for in the rules as a ground for inhibition. But of course, it is subject to the sound discretion of the court. No? So every single time lang ba na may na gustong i-delay, magpa-file na lang na motion for inhibition. Magpa-file na lang na motion for inhibition pa ulit-ulit.
Yeah.
So, even though there is no ground.
Attorney, does this mean that after Judge Alcantara made the decision to voluntarily inhibit from this case, there is no recourse on your end? You'd have to accept the judge's decision.
Well, because nag-inhibit na, di ba? So what's going to happen is...
What happens if everybody in Muntinlupa inhibits? I'm just asking here in a practical way. I'm not a lawyer like Mike Navalio, but I mean, kumbaga, as an ordinary individual, you have a good point. What happens then if all the judges in Muntinlupa inhibit? You said 8 have been inhibited. What if they all inhibited? This is the third drug case. She's been acquitted on the second, right? On two. So nag-iisa na lang ito. What is the recourse for the accused?
Well, most probably the Supreme Court should be designating a judge, no, to be assigned in Muntinlupa if all the judges there are already unavailable. That's
and
the thing.
They...
8 judges.
Okay, how many judges are in Muntinlupa? Let's get to the facts here.
Well, as far as we're concerned, if our calculation is correct, but subject to verification, there's only one judge who has not inhibited himself from trying this case. Only one judge. So there's going to be a raffle, but there's only going to be one judge that's going to be available. And hopefully,
but what's the point of a raffle if all the 8 of the 9 have already inhibited? If it's raffled to the 8, they'll inhibit again.
You said a while ago, Karen, that you're not a lawyer, but as a lawyer, I was asking the same question yesterday because those are questions being asked by lawyers right now. Is there really a genuine raffle in this particular instance, considering that almost all have already recused themselves from trying the case of Laila De Lima, save for, we believe, one? No, so how genuine is the raffle going to be? And is this really a raffle, or is this just a pre
a delaying
tactic and a predetermined assignment of the case? Because you know the reason why there's a raffle, Karen, is because we want to make sure that the judges will not be unduly influenced prior to the assignment of the case. But in this particular instance, based on our calculation, there's only one judge who can actually try this case. So it's not a it's the raffle to me is something that is really not a genuine raffle, so to speak, if that's going to be the situation in the overall context.
So what does the situation have to be, attorney, before you actually take it to the Supreme Court and ask the Supreme Court to assign a judge? Has this
Well,
ever been done? Has this
if
ever
there's
been
no
done?
judge, as far as I'm concerned before, right, if there is if my memory serves me right, if there's going to be a chance wherein the dispensation of justice will be endangered, then the Supreme Court can actually order a replacement of venue or a transfer of venue. That happened in the Maguindanao massacre case, if you would recall, wherein it cannot be tried in Maguindanao because the judges there will be in danger. So they transferred the venue in Quezon City to avoid the miscarriage of justice. And there was only one judge who actually tried the case in its entirety, and that judge was relieved of her other duties, no? So that can be an option, but there is already an intervention coming from the Supreme Court in this case, and there's a directive from the Office of Court Administrator that the case must be finished in the next 9 months. So hopefully that particular circular would still be applicable insofar as the new judge is concerned, whoever gets the raffle, assuming that this is going to be a genuine raffle, right? But hopefully our calculations are wrong, that there's only one judge who can actually try this case in the city of Muntinlupa.
Okay, but then with the order of the court administrator that the third drug case of De Lima, that it should be finished in 9 months, when does the 9 month end? Can you give me the exact date?
Well, that was issued in April, so by the end of the year, this is supposed to be done. But that did not take into consideration that there were two judges who will recuse themselves from trying the case. So hopefully, that particular time frame of the Supreme Court, of the Office of the Court Administrator, still remains to be true.
Yeah. So technically speaking, if the Supreme Court is followed, former Senator Laila De Lima may be free by the end of the year. Or if she's convicted, you'd have to then take the third drug case to the Court of Appeals. It just goes either way.
It just goes either way, supposedly, if it will be followed. But Karen, hopefully, Senator Dario de Lima will be freed much earlier because we have a pending motion for reconsideration insofar as the bail is concerned. And this judge is supposed to have to be the one ruling on that, no? So siguro pinakabahan yung prosecution kasi yung evidence nga nila almost similar, according to them, almost similar facts. And then it's the same trial judge. So of course, that judge was set to rule on the motion for reconsideration. So they filed this motion for voluntary elimination, and to us, it's clearly dilatory because the judge will now rule on the pending motion for reconsideration on bail. So there's a chance that Senator Laila de Lima, hopefully, with all our prayers, could be free by earlier than December.
Okay, but after Judge Alcantara's inhibition, the third drug case and the motion for bail are two different things, right? For a motion for bail to be delayed is injustice itself, regardless who it is, regardless who the person is, because a person is innocent until proven guilty. So a person is staying a day and an additional day in court. In her case, it's more than 6 years at this point. So if Alcantara inhibited, who then can hear the motion for bail? Don't tell me that will be raffled too.
That will be on the same, that will be heard by the judge who will actually be selected. So because whoever the judge who will
So
be
it's
selected to
tied
try the case will.
to the third drug case.
Correct. Yes. So it's actually an incident of the third drug case, a pending incident right now, considering that we filed the motion for reconsideration with the same court.
All right. In the last 6 years, former Senator Laila De Lima was never granted the right to be interviewed. At one point, I remember Sonny Trillanes, former Senator Sonny Trillanes, was in jail, and I interviewed him actually when he was detained. There was a crew that was allowed to come in. So in the last 6 years, we've never really seen. Or we were never really able to tell the story of her state while detained. And after that last attempt, the violence that transpired, how has former Senator Laila de Lima kept herself? I mean, in the times that she's been out and going to court, the reporters have seen her in good spirits. She's quite strong. What has kept her all these 6 years?
Well, I just like to say that the violence is, to me, a clear assassination attempt. I just want to say that because, the security in Camp Crame, it was unexplainable. And until now, there is no clear answer as to why that happened. There are several layers of locks. But all of those locks and security features have been breached by the Abu Sayyaf members. No, but going on to your question, no, why is it that she? What keeps her going? No,
Yeah, it is more than 6 years.
more than 6 years, and only Ninoy Aquino has been jailed as a political prisoner longer than Laila De Lima. No, every time I visit her, she holds her wooden crucifix. No, and that keeps her going. And not a single instance. And I'm telling you, Karen, not a single instance did she say, "Hindi ko na kaya, makiusap na tayo.
Oh, that's
Itigil na natin yung pakikipaglaban." Never did I hear her say that. And in fact, maybe 3, 4 years ago, I always contemplate before I visit the prison, ano kaya sasabihin ko to encourage ma'am? To strengthen her spirits, no? So iisipan ko yan before entering the prison. When I enter the prison afterwards, ako pa yung stronger eh. I get encouragement from Senator Laila De Lima to fight, continue fighting, because it's a very difficult fight, especially during that time. Bodies piling on the streets. It feels like there's no rule of law. It feels like they will just shove everything down your throat. You can't recourse to the courts. You don't even know who to trust anymore. So it was discouraging to me as a young lawyer back then, or as maybe I'm still considerably young right now. So I get discouraged, but I get the strength from Senator Laila Lima. It's the other way around. I thought that I would be the one giving her strength when I visit her, but it's the other way around. Her spirit never wavered. Her spirit remains to be intact. And until now, she's in good spirits because she always trusts the Filipino people, and she always trusts that eventually the rule of law will prevail. I don't know if we think that that is naive and over-idealistic, but that is Senator Laila Lima, and that's the reason why she's in jail right now, because she fought for the rule of law and she fought for human rights in our country. So she remains to be faithful to that particular conviction.
So, attorney, before we close, just let's g give me a rundown as the as a memory of Mike Navalia, the rundown essentially of how many witnesses have already recanted at this point?
Based on our calculation, it's five, no? Kerwin Espinosa, Kerwin Espinosa, Ronnie Dayan, si Ellie. Of course, we have Rafael Ragos. I forgot the other one, but let's say four, right? Just to
So
make sure that it's.
the numbers when it comes to former Senator Laila De Lima is more than 6 years in jail. Of the three drug cases, already two are acquitted. Eight of nine judges in Muntinlupa already inhibited, right? Is that correct? So these are the numbers. Right now, there's one drug case left. So of four witnesses already recanted, of which the four are major. These are the four that actually at one point have said they gave the drug money, they collected the drug money, et cetera, et cetera. So in the third drug case, is there still a witness that actually has not recanted, or the third drug case has nothing to do anymore with a specific witness?
Well, it's all witnesses who are to us untrustworthy, convicted felons. So there are still, like in that
These
particular
are
case,
witnesses in jail.
in
These are
jail.
witnesses of persons deprived of liberty.
Yes, Colango, Capones, who are all saying that they participated in the drug trade in the Bilibid, but are actually an indicted co-conspirators. The Department of Justice does not want to actually charge them. So they are saying we were the ones who were trading drugs, but the Department of Justice does not want to charge them. They're saying that under oath in the witness stand, but the Department of Justice does not want to charge them. It's only Laila De Lima and the other ones who are charged in this case. You must wonder, Karen, why? What is the deal that they are making with these convicted felons? And why is it that they can get away with their self-confessed crimes scot-free, but they threw everything against Senator Lenny De Lima, including the kitchen sink. Why is it that there is selective prosecution? What's the deal here? We were the ones actually, afterwards, after Capones took the witness stand and confessed to drug trading, the Department of Justice does not want to charge him. We were the ones, as lawyers of Senator Lenny De Lima, who filed a complaint affidavit against Capones. That was dismissed by the prosecutor's office under the direct control of the Department of Justice. Why?
What could it be, attorney, that it's because the reason they don't want to charge him is Capones could be in life for something else? So technically charging him would be immaterial at this point?
Well, every crime, right? Every crime that you commit must be charged, whatever other crime. So, you know, me committing murder does not exempt me from being prosecuted for another crime that I will commit, right? So it is really a politically charged decision. And it's not even that he is qualified to become state witness, because he cannot be state witness because he's the most guilty and he is a convicted of crime involving moral turpitude. So there's no excuse. Aside from the fact that there's selective justice in this particular, selective prosecution in this particular instance.
All right. On that note, Attorney Dino De Leon, thank you so much. And I do hope to hear an update in terms of the raffling of the case for a new judge. If the raffle is on Monday, would it then be possible that by next week there would be a new judge by that time?
There's a possibility. There's a raffling and there's going to be a new judge by that time.
Okay.
Yes, it's going to be next week. Hopefully, we're crossing our fingers.
All right. I'm curious, once again, as I close, I'm not a lawyer. Is it possible then that because 8 of 9 have been inhibited in Muntinlupa for this raffling, following the order of the Supreme Court that the case must be finished within 9 months, that's the end of the year, can the Supreme Court, under its authority, order that the next judge can no longer inhibit once it's fallen into his or her court?
Can no longer inhibit, maybe without valid grounds, like this one. To us, it's not a mandatory
The Supreme
inhibition.
Court can. The Supreme Court can.
Wait,
can
I haven't heard of that
order. Has it ever been done?
But the Supreme Court can technically deny a judge from voluntary inhibiting if the grounds are not present. Of course, because it's the duty of the judge to try a case. So if there's no valid ground, then the Supreme Court can reject if ever the party is
an inhibition. So that's
yes.
So technically, the Supreme Court, is it fair to say, attorney, the Supreme Court can step in at this point?
Can, actually. And right now, we're even contemplating on filing an MR. We haven't decided yet because, you know, the judge has just...
I mean, why don't you file one? There's no
the
law.
Judge has... Because we don't want to, you know, this is not an ordinary case, right? Judge Alcantara has decided based on his conscience, supposedly, that he wants to inhibit himself. So we might want to respect that. So we're under consultation with Senator Ray De Lima right now, if we should file a motion for reconsideration. Because, you know, we have to respect as well the discretion of Judge Alcantara. We don't want to be forcing his hand to, mahirap ha, maging judge. Diba? And at this particular point in time, inhibition, there must be a reason and we want to respect that. But we are consulting with Senator Ray De Lima if indeed we should be filing a motion for reconsideration.
On that note, I want to thank you for this discussion, Attorney Dino De Leon. And I do hope at one point they allow an interview with former Senator Laila De Lima. Thank you.
Maybe you should try and then we will move for it.
All right. Okay.
Thank you,
take care. You take care. Have a good weekend.